Okay, I've done what I can. From here, we just gotta hope it holds up. I'm just gonna keep working. You guys should be able to hear me okay. Hopefully you can see me okay. We lost a little bit of time there, so gotta make up for lost time. Hopefully we don't get disconnected. What's up, Just City Space? What's the project? I don't know what the project is yet. I'm waiting for the customer to tell me. So I'm just spraying stuff. Until I think it looks good. Seems to be holding up this time, so hopefully people come back. Alright, hat 3 of 5, red down. 4 of 5 coming up. Trying to go a little bit faster. What's up, Irby Wolf? Yeah, I got it working. Hopefully it holds up. Just turn down the settings a little bit, hopefully. I think our router for the internet, I think it's overheating, man. I think it's been dying a slow, painful death, and I think it's finally just, it's ready to die. And so I turned down the settings for the live stream. Gotta turn down that bit rate, you know, to turn down that quality. Seems to be holding up. Cross your fingers. You know what I'm saying? Hopefully I'm not jinxing it. You know, it could have been at the same time too that something in the house was just deciding to do an update or something like that right at the same time. Now I've turned down the settings and that update's finished and now everything's gonna work great. Maybe I didn't have to turn down the settings. I don't know, but let's not mess with it. Let's leave it alone. I don't think it'll even make that much of a noticeable difference. So. I think we're good. Let's leave it alone. And the only thing is I am trying to make up for lost time, so I'm going to be working a little bit, not so much faster, but maybe I'm just going to zone out and not talk so much. We was having too much fun on the part one. We got to mean real serious business on this part two now. So that later today, all I got to do is just a little bit of work. Here at 2 o'clock is my normally programmed break. So, what's up, Cody Adams? How's it going? Four of five. Oh wait, let's not forget about his hat. Okay. 5 of 5. Red back out. Okay. One second. Yay. Gotta remember to take meds. And we keep working. Out of red. Saludos desde Perú, bro. Pero ¿cómo hago para que sea sponsor? Oh my god, what is this? No wonder. Okay, so delete that one. That's funny. Let's delete that. I didn't know it had posted all them videos just that quick. That's why there's only 7 viewers. YouTube just had all kinds of fun with me trying to post videos, and apparently videos that were queued that never happened, it decided to use the live feed as that video and it posted it. YouTube can be fun sometimes. And I'm glad I went and checked, because I was like, well, why is there only 7 people? That don't make no sense. And I go and look, and it's like, oh, because my channel suddenly posted 4 videos all in a row, and people are probably all like seeing different things. And yep. All right, that's that. Let's go back to number 1. Let's get some orange mixed up. And we can keep on keeping on. I gotta need it. Got a little confusing, yeah. Yeah, it's just YouTube has this weird thing about if you post too many videos, then like it won't recommend your videos out to people, and like, yeah, considering it was using them as live feeds, and YouTube does this thing where it lets people know when you're live, and if I kept going live, but they were just weirdly short videos, and yeah, people were like getting mass notified right now. Probably not really good for me. You know, Mike's Brush went live again. He's going live on top of live. One live after on top of the other. Non-stop live. He's double live. Definitely not good for the algorithm gods. Alright, got some orange loaded. I'm just glad it's holding up right now, to be honest with you. I'm glad it's not just dying. And that we are still live. So now I'm just gonna start working in some orange. So here we start the orange on hat 1 of 5. It's all fun and games doing one hat until you have to do 5 hats with fire. See that? It's gonna look like a bloody mess here for a minute. Especially because it's wet. It's going on kind of wet. Maybe you might have thrown a little too much reducer in there. It's still coming across. And all we need is a nice orange base. Go in with that red, right? To lay down our yellow on. Then we're gonna make them poppity pop. These edges with the orange are not really super important. I'm just kind of using them to really avoid the overspray going over everywhere, because I do want it to just kind of stay in these areas. And if I just go trying to just do the whole thing with orange here, that overspray is going to just go everywhere. So I'm just trying to keep it in certain spots. And at the same time, if we can use it to give just a slight impression of a curve and accent the red, that's perfect. All I'm really trying to do, see that? Tap. I'm just going to take a little bit more orange and throw it in here, just so it the paint is a little bit more thicker and consistent, because it's really, I threw in too much reducer, it's kind of watered down and reducing the effect of the orange. It's still pretty good. Thank you. What's up, Graham? How's it going? How's it going? What it is. We got that side, we got that side, we got this guy, yep. So we're going to the next one. Honestly, if we could get to the part where I could spray the candy over the flames, and then all I gotta worry about is detailing out this guy, that's plenty, plenty progress for today. I do apologize for the internet connection issues. I'm not sure what's really going on with that. It seems to better just lowering the settings, so it's a knock on wood. Angle on the camera is also right up on my face. You're seeing what I'm seeing. Like the camera is right here up on my cheek. So if you ever wanted to get a bird's eye view or get a really good view of what it's like, running smooth now? Yeah, nice. I'm glad. Thank you. drifting off the camera. Drift, just drifting away off the camera. Just going off in the country land where I won't be seen by no man. Orange on hat number two. Oh wait, almost forgot the side here. Almost forgot the side. Okay. sides. One's ready for yellow. On to the next one. Hat four. That's five. I'm telling you, if I could get him to the point where I could just spray the yellow candy over and the flames be done, and then I could just, you know, come and focus on this later, we'd be good. We'd be good. I just want to get the fire done. Seems to be running smoothly now, right? Yeah. I hope the quality's not crap. I hope it looks okay. Can you tell any difference from earlier? If you were here earlier. Probably not much of a difference if you're watching on the phone or something. But if you're watching on a TV or something like that, it might be a little, just a little different, just a little bit, not as clean. Looks fine? Cool. Cool, cool. Looks good in Australia, all right. That's good enough for me. Gets the Australia stamp of approval. We're almost there. We're almost there, ladies and gentlemen. Gotta do orange on one more hat, then we could start moving on to some yellow and really start making these things pop. The yellow is really gonna come in there and make it, you know, really brighten up. And all I've done is just lay down a really good base with this red and orange. And I don't know how well you can see it on camera because the camera makes the colors look super bright, but you see these little areas here where it's not completely covered. It's like red because you can still see, I mean, a little bit of like pinkish, you know, over that, around that red. But that's why we're going to use candy. And I'm probably going to use like a tequila yellow candy at the very end to really turn those spots all like a nice yellowy tone. But before I do that, I'm probably going to go through and just lay in some nice like white streaks and some nice bright spots with white before I lay the candy in. And that'll be after I've already done yellow as well. So the candy will darken up that yellow and tone it. And then as well as bring any of that red and bring it all together. Anything looks good at 3 a.m. Looks good, sounds good on the computer here. Nice, nice, thank you, sir. All right, so there we got that one. 4 of 5, 5 of 5 is next. So these hats are for one of the farms out here. And I guess they grow some good chili. A lot of the farms out here grow chili. It's one of the kind of things, is the Pueblo chili. And yeah. But if you want to get a hold of this particular farm, the name of the farm is Di Tomaso Farms. Yeah, if you want to get yourself some hands on some chili, some vegetables, that kind of thing, they got all of it. Thank you. back done. And we can finally move on to some yellow. Yellow loaded up.
Maybe I should just do that. Shake this up. Oh, did it try to mess up? Oh yeah, we're jamming now, boy. I need to turn off the lights to get the rave lights out. Get some glow sticks, boy. I'd be jamming, I'd be out here. Gotta get the body loose, you know what I'm saying? Can you guys hear that music pretty good or no? Probably not when I'm coughing like that. You can't, huh? Okay. Yellow. Yellow.
So I'm using a brighter yellow than I would normally use. I think, what is this color called? The Wicked Opaque Bismuth Vandate Yellow, or 0081. It's part of the Wicked Opaques. And I'm using this one today because I'm gonna use tequila yellow, the tequila candy, to lay over the top. The tequila candy is a little bit deeper than this, this yellow here. So when I lay the tequila yellow, it'll actually shift the color on this and not just go over and not do much. So in order to make the candy kind of more vibrant and poppy, I use a little bit brighter yellow, and then I'm gonna come back with some white highlights over this. And that way when I lay the candy over, it'll really shift all that stuff. So now we have the red in there, we got the orange layers. And again, when we lay that candy over, it's really gonna blend all that in and give us that nice mwah! But for now, let's just get all this fire laid out on all these hats, and then we can lay some candy in. I believe we can get it done. We have about another hour and 15 minutes before I have to go pick up Violet from school, so. Thank you. We're just gonna keep chugging along here. Keeping it pumped, keeping it moving. First primer surface and after painting? Question mark. What? What's the question? After painting? Question mark. Like, clear coat? What are you talking about? What are you talking about, Willis? What's your question? Technically, after painting, you're done. You're done painting. You polish it? First primer surface. Mike, first primer surface and after painting. I assume, like, you mean like clear coat? It's all gonna depend on what you're painting on. What is the progress? Oh shit, I don't know what you're trying to say. It's all gonna depend on what you're trying to paint on. What are you painting? What are you trying to paint? What are you? If you're laying primer, you're gonna be painting on something that needs primer. So then you would, I mean, usually after you lay primer, you lay a base coat, or you lay some kind of a, you know, a color. I mean, it's something that could be done completely in Createx. So you could lay Autoboard and Sealer primer. Then you can lay like Createx Sealer color followed by Wicked color, and then you can lay down like a 40-50 clear. But it's really gonna depend if you're airbrushing, like what are you airbrushing. Primer, sand, paint, clear. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. Jess knows. Jess has been around for enough projects. She knows the process. She's helped with a lot around here. think he's asking if you prime it before you paint it. I mean, he starts off by saying first you primer the surface, so he knows to prime it. And then after the painting, I mean, you would, like, I assume if you're talking about doing artwork or something like that, you would clear coat it. But I mean, if you're talking about a whole complete paint job, usually after you lay primer, you would lay a color. Right? You prep your primer, you sand it up, you do what you need to do to it. Then you lay down your color layer. Then you would lay down your artwork. Then you would lay down clear, or inner coat clear, depending on what you're doing, graphics or whatever, you know. And then you lay down your clear, your regular clear. You cut that back, lay down some more clear. So you got it smooth, then you would polish it. And hopefully that helps you out. I mean, I don't know. Again, it's all going to depend on what you're painting, because that's if, like, you're doing a vehicle or a motorcycle or something. But if you're doing a pair of shoes, 9 times out of 10, you don't have to lay primer. If you're doing a canvas, I mean, you really don't need to use primer most of the time. Unless you're trying to go for a certain color or effect or something. So yeah, I'm not sure. It's all like all the videos, right? It all depends on what you're doing. What's up, Playday? How's it going? Gee, did we totally forget the orange on this too?
What is going on? I totally forgot it.
I hope this is the only one I forgot it on. Jesus. It's all right. I think we can make it work.
That one, 3, a 5, 4, a 5, man, we only got an hour. We're starting to run out of time. We're on 4 out of 5. 4 out of 5 is not bad, he says. All right. I like your enthusiasm, Cody. 4 out of 5 is not bad. We got this, I believe. You can do it, man.
No, yeah, I
was just trying to get them all. I was trying to have this all kind of by a certain spot by the time I had to go get Violet. And I still think we're gonna be at that spot, but it's gonna be close. Now, do you guys... should I come back live tomorrow? And when I do the chilies, I'll have all the fire done tomorrow. And I'll just go live doing all the chilies in the morning. Has to be bright and early in the morning, because that's when I'm gonna do it. I do believe we've made good progress today. We did 4 hours on these, which is not bad at all. Out of yellow, let me mix up some more yellow.
probably do another couple hours tomorrow morning. And they'll be nice and done, ready to head out the door. You know, I mean, it took me an hour to get one done. Like the original one. And that was with me working extra hard, having to build up the layers of paint because it was soaking in and stuff. And I'm glad I had the foresight to do a little bleed checker today because it did solve and help some issues. So, but if you guys like watching this, I mean, could I always go back live tomorrow since it's all set up and stuff? I don't really have to do anything. And I'm glad it kind of calmed down and we could actually work on some videos again. Because I actually got quite busy there for a second. Sounds good to you for tomorrow? Cool. Hopefully there'll be more than just you, but I'm down. I mean, I could just get on in the morning when I'm gonna be out here anyway doing them, so I could just go live. You're recuperating from eye surgery? Oh man. Like LASIK or something? Or like you had to have some surgery, like real, like something was wrong? Like, well, I mean, obviously, I mean, I don't know. Hopefully it wasn't bad. And yeah, I'll definitely be live tomorrow for you. Get you a little entertainment, I mean. I need to get back in the habit of going live and but you guys already know what it is. We get busy around tax season. Happens every year. Get busy for tax season. Ad revenue goes down, so it's a nice time to really just take a break. So you know, January, February is always kind of slower. And as it ramps up into the spring and the summer, it's time to get back and cracking on these videos and stuff, so. Clean up. I call it a DNC. I mean, it sounds like it's something you've had done multiple times. I don't know. I've never had my eyes like that. So.
Hopefully it's not too bad, though.
You can still watch YouTube, so I assume it's all good. Five of five. We'll get the yellow on there. We can do some white highlights. Now I need to go and check them though. Make sure I got all, yeah, yellow on all of them, right? Okay. Five of five. Let's get this yellow, baby. Then we can do some white, lay some candy, and then I'll see you guys tomorrow. This is me keeping my eye on the prize. It's like all I gotta do is just this yellow, do some candy, and then we out of here. Gotta keep the eye on the prize. Eyeball maintenance. Oh, got a cramp. Ah, I've been sitting for too long. Oh, man. Ouch. Ah. All right. Come on. Ah, you stupid leg. What's up, K-Spec? Man down, gotta hydrate. Yeah, I know. All I've had is that pineapple juice and a little bit of drink of water. Maybe I should just get this water in me real quick. Happens a lot on my bad hip side, man. And usually it just been sitting too long and it's like it starts happening. I've been working out hard though. Hard, boy. Boy's been getting heavy on them weights. To really push myself and get myself back into shape. Gonna really try to push it this summer. I honestly need like a couple of good summers, man. So your boy has some money to retire on, cause it's just getting rough. Okay, just gotta do the backside. That's okay, we already got it perfect. Okay, let's do some quad. I'm gonna do some white details onto the flames. Oh, I see the connection is so great right now. And the internet just don't know what it wanna do. Is it gonna even out or what? What's going on here? Come on, Mr. Internet, stop doing this. Right, we still have white loaded up from earlier. Man, I hope you guys can hear me good. Yep, I'm pretty sure our router's dying, bro. It's fucking dying a slow death, cause it's like, I lowered the settings and it was good. And there it is, there's the notification over here. You see the yellow? Come in here. Better go swap it. Yeah, I know. After we go do that tonight when you get off of work. I still have to go get Palon. You gonna go with me to go get Palon too? The Chinese and Russian hackers, dog. You know you say that, and I know you just joking, but our website has actually had lots of Russian and Chinese hackers try to actually break into the website. Yeah. Oh my god, man. It's not smoothing back out either. But no, I honestly think here at home, it's really just our router is dying. We've had it for probably 2 years, maybe a little bit longer than that now, the same one. And I don't know, it's our internet has slowly and surely just gotten worse over time. One thing I noticed is that it's just been running hotter. It's just hot now. Like you go and you put your hand over it and it's warm. Blowing out warm air. And so one thing I had done to try to make it survive was put a little fan on it. And that actually seemed to help for a while. But I guess I hadn't gone live in a while and now it's... Now it's trying. Now it's kicking the bucket. Now it's dying. So, it's alright. They should swap it out for us, no problem. It's the reason we pay for a rental modem, right? We don't pay to own one. Because if it goes bad, then it's like you're in charge of fixing it, not me. It does look like it's smoothed out. As I'm talking smack about it, it's smoothed out. Alright, highlights. Hat number one. Got them all the way around. Boom, you see that? We're almost to the candy! If I stop jibber-jabbering, maybe we'll actually get to it. I'm trying to believe. See that, right? It's just like a highlight over the top of the flame. That's actually the flame, because once we lay the candy over, it's gonna really push all these effects over here in the back. It's gonna push them all down. It's gonna really bring out that red and turn it really red. And yeah, I'm excited for the candy part because I know how much it shifts these flames around when I do them in this fashion. Thank you. is at hat number two. The beer, bro, still wet. Yeah, yeah, it's fine. We'll finish all these up tomorrow. Three of five. How much time we got? 30 minutes. I believe.
I still believe. Oh no, the internet's like.
I hope it's still good for you guys, like watching. I'm not sure what it looks like. I think it just gets all choppy or something. I'm not sure. Starting to freeze here and there. Yeah. Yeah. Hopefully we have it figured out by tomorrow. We'll be right back.
gosh.
Oh, I could almost smell the candy already. Almost. Five? Is it really hat number five? Did we get all white on all of them? All right. All right. Let's throw some candy on these. Rinse out this color real quick. Give this candy a good shakety shake. What's up, Justice? How's it going? Bad boy up. All right. And so let's get you guys a good view right here. So we're just gonna lay that right on over. See how that just makes it, oh boy, that's hot. All right, now look at the side, ready, you all ready? Look at it, yeah, I'm gonna start over here, real nice and light, right over that red, that yellow, that orange, that white, oh boy. Look at that bad boy. Ooh, boy. Oh, careful. You burn yourself. Careful. That's all we need, just a little of hotness. Just a little of hotness, look at that. See that right there? Look at this. Tell me that don't look hot. Tell me that don't look hot. Let's just block the load I like. buddy. That's that fire. That's that fire. All that work we did paid off. Pet number two. See, layering that candy on, that's probably the best part right there. That really brings that whole thing together. Look at that. Woo-hoo! Woo-hoo, partner, yeah! That looking real nice. And to get a better shot, it's probably like right there so you can see the side. Do the side real quick. That really does it, doesn't it? That really does it, doesn't it? Laying that candy in, woohoo! It really does make it look nice. So tomorrow morning, I'll be back live for you guys, and we'll just focus in on these chili guys. What color candy is that? This is the magic color. That's what it is. This is the tequila yellow. The magic fire color. Make any scribbles look like fire, trust me. You just scribble some stuff, throw some tequila gold over it, and it'll turn it into some fire, boy. Woo-wee, look at that. If you like get an angle without the glare like that, oh. I was blocking it with my hand, I guess. See all them reds and them oranges and all that stuff? It all comes together. You throw that candy in. Try to warn you that it's a woo!
That music is perfect for the cowboy hats.
Alright.
I do believe we got all the fire. Making sure to rinse this guy out.
Okay, well there you go guys, we actually made it.
all the way through the fire. And now tomorrow, I just got to come do the... Trying to get a good shot of the fire there. Tomorrow, I just got to come and do the... There you go. Right there. I just got to come and do the jalapenos tomorrow. The chilies. You know, the big chili ones, you know. Chili! We're going to do those tomorrow. And that's it. We'll be done on this project, on this hat. Thank you guys, as always, for watching. I'm sorry about all the internet issues. Hopefully, we'll try to have it solved by tomorrow. And, yeah. Thank you guys, as always, for watching. And we'll see you guys next time. Later, everybody.